I did the first State of Emergency game all the way back in episode 7 about 2.5 years ago. It was one of the most pleasant surprises I've had doing this show. Expecting a naff GTA 3 clone, but instead getting a fun, chaotic arcade experience. So let's see how State of Emergency 2 went. Last time, we seemingly took down the corporation that had taken control of America, mainly by blowing them all sky high. But 4 years later, it looks like they survived and regained their power and got even more. This game has a more cinematic story mode as opposed to it being told through text boxes like the first game. We open on Capital City, where we get to see corporation enforcers beating down members of the public. There's a whole row of them stood outside the Justice Corps building, not noticing a woman above sneaking in through a window. It's Anna Price, or Libra, from the first game. She's speaking with Ricky Fang, Freak, over the radio. She hacks into one of their computers and finds some blueprints for one of the corporation's maximum security prisons. She sends them over to Freak and he tells her to get out quickly. But she pokes around a bit more and finds a file on something called Project Empyrean. She's about to download it and send it to Freak for encryption, but she's surrounded and arrested by the Justice Corps. Freak looks sad for about 2 seconds and then turns up the TV. Roy McNeil, Mac, and Eddie Raymond's Bull had also been arrested right after we blew up the corporation headquarters in the first game. Mac especially was a big grab for them, and they planned to execute him live on TV the next night, which is why Libra was sneaking around for those prison blueprints. That just leaves Freak and one more leader of Freedom free, who he calls. Hector Soldado, Spanky, tells Freak that he has a guy inside the prison already. The next night, we see Mac being marched to the chair. He's put in, and as the automated voice asks if he wants an upgrade to his standard execution, Freak hacks in. He can't stop them turning on the gas, but Spanky's inside man has left something under his seat. He then turns off Mac's restraints. When the gas cloud fades, Mac's wearing a gas mask and has a gun. The studio audience leaves as I just sit back in my chair shooting at the prison guards that come after me. So this game changes from the beat-em-up-esque style of the original to a more over-the-shoulder third-person shooter. This is 2006, many games are doing that style. For this opening bit, I have infinite health so I can get used to the aiming. And I'm not a fan. Vertical feels like it moves too slow while at the same time it moves too much when I just want a slight movement. I also make sure to destroy any bits of the environment that I can, it'll be important. After a while, Mac's legs are freed and he takes a headset from a dead guard to stay connected to Freak. The alarm goes off and the place goes into lockdown. Pausing the game and looking at my objectives, I can see that each level has 3 bonus objectives. One for finishing under a certain time, one for destroying enough property, and a third one I don't figure out for a while. For the sake of my sanity, I'm not going to go into detail on every object I destroy, that would make some level descriptions go on forever. The guards mainly come in above me and I quickly take them all out. Freak tells Mac his best escape option is through the main cell block and opens the door to let me out. I head through the corridor and get shooting more guards. I'm still in the tutorial section so I'm still invincible at the moment. I get a new weapon, a pistol. Picking it up suddenly means the mini SMG I started with now has limited ammo. Is that how it works? You have infinite ammo until you own a second gun? I open up the next door and take advantage of my current invincibility to explode a barrel in my own face with no repercussions. There are crates nearby I can shoot for more weapons and ammo, including a shotgun. The red light goes away so things look less ugly as I open up the next door. I barge through the metal detector, take on more guards, and find that for some reason this game has trouble picking up my PS2 controller. There'll be a lot of controller missing screens I'm editing around. At the next door, Mac and Freak have a little conversation. He finally sends Mac the prison blueprints, which has a mini-map to the hood. I enter the cell block where Freak says there are 4 warden officers, each one with a switch that will release prisoners. If I free all the prisoners, I can sneak out in the ensuing riot. The 4 officers are up a ramp in each corner of this room. Each one is surrounded by a group of guards. I take out one and flip the first switch. This causes a new group to spawn in and zero in on the office I just flipped the switch in. I actually have a health bar now as I dash along for the next office. I take out the group protecting it and flip the second switch. That's half of the prisoners freed. However, on my way to the third office, I get killed. I actually struggled with this part and died a lot. There's one thing that could have helped, but I won't find out about it until after I've beaten the main story. It doesn't help that I'm also using ammo, shooting every tiny monitor trying to up the damage count as much as possible. After, no joke, half an hour of dying on the first level, I find I can increase the aim sensitivity just a little, so I can at least aim faster. First switch pulled, second switch pulled, there are also these guys in the balconies that are easy to miss if you're focusing on the ones barreling up to you. Third switch pulled, then next to the final switch, I achieve the destruction target by causing damage worth a combined $150,000. I pull the final switch, which causes them to send even more guards in to stop the riot. Before we break out, I have to kill the guards and stop them slaughtering all the prisoners. I gun them all down and escape through a service corridor in one of the warden offices. On the way out, a dying prisoner who knows Mac's name gets his attention. He uses his last breath to tell Mac he needs to stop Empyrean and to tell Libra, as she'll know what to do. But right now, the next goes to Breakout Bull. Completing the destruction target unlocks Bob in multiplayer. I think he's the guy that just died. That was Chapter 1, Execution. Next is Chapter 2, Free Bull. Mac almost gets himself killed by a security drone. Freak couldn't disarm them, so I have to deal with it. At this point the game tells me about leaning. It takes me a few tries because I kept pressing the wrong shoulder button and walking right into its line of fire. There are many of these and I just work my way down the corridor taking them out. I reach a switch to open a door then get shot in the back. Turns out there was one more hidden away. But I open the door anyway and just run through to heal. I take out the last two here since I need that damage counter to increase and go up the ladder. On this floor I now have both drones and guards to deal with at once. It's easy to forget about the drones, run after a guard trying to shoot him and then get gunned down yourself. What kills me this time is getting knocked down by a drone and then standing up right into a guard's shot. What follows is just more leaning around corners blowing up drones and shooting guards. It goes on for a bit until I reach some stairs and take them up to the roof, where there's a sniper rifle waiting for me. Freak says not to waste the ammo, so I take out the first guard with just my pistol. But the others are either moving or just too far away, so I have to use the rifle for them. I wish I'd upped the brightness recording this game. Watching these night levels back, I have a hard time telling what's going on. I climb up the first ladder I find and start picking off any guards I can see. Once it's clear, I walk across to the next section and get spotted, but I blow him away before he can alert the others. I once again climb up a nearby ladder and shoot down all the guards in my view. Once I've got them all, I climb down and realise there was one hiding right around the corner from me the entire time. Behind him, I go inside and up more stairs. I exit slightly higher up, get to the nearest ladder, and once again pick off guards I can reach. Once they're gone, I enter the area marked Block B. I take out the nearby guards and the one sniping me from a distance. Moving on, there's a few more and a drone before I can safely find a ladder down into the cell block. They have Bull on his knees ready to execute him in front of the other prisoners. I mess it up first time by shooting one in the chest, not killing him and going for the other, allowing him to kill Bull. Next time I play smarter and headshot the both of them. Bull takes a headpiece and I have to cover him, killing all the guards while he runs around freeing the prisoners. It's simple, first take out the two in his way, then the four that come out of the warden's office. Bull can then reach the switch and open some cells. I look away for a second and Bull plummets to near death from two grenades from the second office. He pulls the second switch and gets trapped inside by four more guards, but one I kill drops a grenade and Bull runs right into it and gets himself killed. Next time I reach that point, there's no grenades and Bull has taken only the tiniest bit of damage. I realise I have infinite rifle ammo for this section so I can just keep firing like crazy until I hit something. Bull pulls the third switch and I take out the last four in no time, letting him release the last of the prisoners. Bull then opens up our escape door and the chapter is complete. This time I didn't accomplish any of the bonus objectives, I just couldn't find much to destroy. Now for Chapter 3, Breakout. We can't get out alone, we need the help of all these prisoners. Freak, Max and I map the controls to open the shutters. Here I can play as both Mac and Bull, being able to swap between them with the select button. I run up the stairs to the left and start picking off the guards shooting at the prisoners. But then I start getting shot at from all sides. In the end, I get killed turning around to face the one left shooting at me. Next time, I start with the right set of stairs, where they were all pouring out from last time. I then shoot out all the ones on the ground floor again. Once they're all dead, I use the free time to smash up everything I can. After a few minutes, I finally get going down that right corridor. I switch to Bull as I use up all of Mac's ammo breaking lights. Mac just stands in view of a drone, but since he isn't the player character at the moment, it doesn't see him. More guards come out and they're easily dealt with, granting me a massive amount of screens to destroy and a switch that opens doors to let in even more prisoners. Next is getting the exit open. Freak tells me there are explosives in the armory. It's on the opposite set of stairs that I died on first time, with the doors opening and letting more guards through. So I just fight my way through the new lot and reach this door requiring Bull's strength. I have to smash the shoulder buttons to fill the bars and smash the doors open. Inside is a load of weapon refills and the remote mines. I go to the main doors, plant the mines, and blow a huge hole open for the prisoners to escape. I head outside and right away I'm being shot at by a guy in a turret. Freak tells me there's a helicopter somewhere around me to escape with. Only Mac has a sniper rifle, so I hang back inside the building to take out all the turret users I can reach. This triggers a few normal guards to try and fire on the prisoners, but I take them all down. Turns out I missed one turret, so I get rid of him and get running around the back. I run up the slope taking out guards, with others from a distance chipping away at Bull's health. Once at the top, I swap to Mac and snipe those guys. I follow the path inside, up a ladder, out and back inside again where I go down a ladder and at the door I'm now being shot at by a helicopter. It hangs about above just unloading minigun fire at me. It's a bit of a hassle with it moving everywhere, but after a couple minutes I manage to snipe the pilot and bring it down. We can also see the helicopter I want to use below. I follow the path, go down a ladder, and take out a group of guards by blowing up a fuse box. Behind them is another door for Bull to break open. This building is my target, so I decide to snipe the guards inside from a distance. I go into the building where I can finally heal Bull and grab some rockets, and flip the switch to open the huge gate and let the prisoners further in. This also opens the gate leading to the helicopter. I fight my way through the last batch of guards and can finally get on that helicopter. I need to use this to deactivate the laser gates. The helicopter can fire both its chain gun and homing rockets. There are 4 generators marked on my map to destroy. There's also a load of turrets to blow up to add to my damage counter. And there's usually a few of them surrounding the generators, as I find while taking out the first one. It's quite easy to lose a lot of health to a turret, as they normally don't get fully going until you're directly above them and can't aim at them. On destroying a second generator, I reach $160,000 of damage and reach the destruction target. With nothing else to delay me, I can just take out the last two and remove that laser gate, releasing all the prisoners while we fly off. I unlock the Enforcer in multiplayer and the Ghetto map for the same mode. Speaking of the Ghetto, next is Chapter 4, The Ghetto. Spanky has been watching the prison escape on TV and laughing his ass off, Freak calling him to make sure he's watching. Freak says that Mac and Bull will be meeting Spanky soon, but Spanky also has an Enforcer unit coming right after him. However, this is Spanky's territory, so he has a turret mounted on his roof. So the first part of this chapter has me manning this infinite ammo turret against a huge mob of Enforcers. There are some explosive barrels and cars left around to blow up on groups, but even then you still have to be careful and think about the order you're killing these guys. Because as soon as they reach their position, they will continue to shoot you, and I die the first time. It seems I was close the first time, as on my second attempt, I clear that wave after about the same amount of time. Spanky asks Freak when the Enforcers even started bothering with the Ghetto, as they normally ignore it. Freak says they're also getting involved in the drugs business, so Spanky guesses they were trying to eliminate the competition. The killers are still the main dealers, that one gang out of the many that I had to deal with in a few missions in the first game. They figure that if Spanky warns the killers about the Enforcers, they'll help in return. Because Spanky holds 2 pistols, that means he tends to fire twice for each shot and use up your ammo twice as fast. This level is a bit different. Instead of being linear, I have an entire section of a city to explore and a huge destruction target of $200,000. So first I just get running around shooting every single thing I can find. Phone boxes, bus stops, shop windows, every single light up sign. After about 5 minutes of just shooting everything, some Enforcers show up to try and kill me. I actually lose a lot of health as I run out of ammo just as they show up and have to run around picking more up. Soon after, while shooting signs, I accidentally enter a killer's club, White Lines. He explains to the leader what's happening and he joins up with me to help find out where the corporation's dealers are, which Freak marks down on the map. Well, first he has to deal with me shooting more of the scenery. Although I naturally pass by and kill the first dealer. Cue a few more minutes of destruction, even taking out the light bulbs and traffic lights. This destruction target stuff is very tedious. It's not fun or satisfying just shooting out tiny computer monitors or flimsy shop windows. Compared to the first game's more chaotic forms of destruction, it just doesn't compare. And I lose a lot of progress on that when an Enforcer kills me. On my second try, I take out the second dealer. Luckily, the pedestrians here will also take on the Enforcers themselves and even kill some for me. Another minute of smashing windows and I take out the third dealer, actually being guarded by Enforcers this time. After over 20 minutes in this chapter smashing shit, I finally get that $200,000 in damage dealt. And the good thing is, even if I'm checkpointed to before this if I die, I still get to keep the completed target. Without any more of that faffing about to do, I shoot out the fourth dealer, then the fifth. I approach the final dealer who tries to run, only for the leader and another to grab him. They drop him before Spanky for the interrogation minigame. I have to hold X and let go when the bar reaches just the right spot. Too early and you don't hit hard enough. Too late and you hit too hard and kill him. And you have to get it right 3 times. I honestly found it way too easy to kill the guy. When I do it right, the guy says he gets the drugs at the abandoned police station. He says it's a new drug called Empyrean. The 3 of us are then surrounded by Enforcers. I just kill one for a shotgun and very easily plow through the rest of them. Trey, the leader, says we need to go back to his club and recruit some more of his crew to take on that drug lab with. So I head back where I'm told I could now recruit gang members allied with Sparky. So I start with all the killers in the club and then run all over the map recruiting even more. I find the police and gun half of them down through the window. Then when I go inside, I just barely survive and take out the ones hiding out above. I grab the remote mines in one of the rooms and get the old police station marked on my map. Of course, there's a large group of them outside waiting for me. I end up wiping out most of my gang myself as they congregate between me and the police while we're shooting at each other, but I was a hit from death anyway, so I don't last long. Next time, instead of hanging outside, I just barge in and shoot at everyone. It works, but I don't have much health left. and next go down to the car park where there's even more of them waiting and hiding behind cover. I kill a good chunk of them, but die again. Next time I get them all, but once again just barely. I plant a mine on the stockpile of Empyrean, belt it outside, and wipe it off the face of the planet. As the chapter ends, Freak tells Spanky to find a way into the docks. I unlock Trey and Spanky for multiplayer. Chapter 5, The Docks. Spanky watches the helicopter carrying Mac and Bull crash land further on. $425,000 for the destruction target has me thinking, what the hell do they want from me? To start, I'm immediately attacked by enforcers, but I still have a few gang members to pack me up. There's not many, so they go down in no time. I enter this building and through a fence, I see a floating state of emergency logo. I don't know what to do with it yet as my attempt at shooting it doesn't work and I can't knock down the fence. So I just exit out of the other side to see that Mac and Bull are cornered. So I just shoot one and the majority of them forget the other two and come for me. They're bad shots and I kill them all, then quickly sweep the last lot dealing with the others. Also, Mac's a fucking dick, still looking down on the guy who just saved his life and worked alongside him in the first game. Bull's actually grateful. They see a huge Empyrean shipment and the three pull together everything they know about it. They want more answers and an enforcer just happens to still be alive near them, so it's interrogating time. It takes me way too long to get three successful hits in without killing him. He says that the corporation plans to sell Empyrean to other countries' governments to control their populations. Empyrean is designed to affect the user's brain to suppress free will and make them more likely to just do as they're told. On top of that, it drastically lowers the user's life expectancy. Spanky is furious they've been selling it in his neighbourhood, to which the enforcer says it was a final test before using it on people who matter, as he says. Spanky gives him a much deserved bone crushing. While that's going on, the corporation have brought in a tank. Well, Spanky's done his job and he's not taking on a tank, so he bails. I have to get Bull close enough to the tank to steal it. I have to time pressing X so that Bull can run between cover without getting hit. I fail right away. The way to do it is to make Bull start running the second the shell explodes, though there are some shots that are too quick even for that. Once Bull gets up close, he throws some tear gas inside and makes the driver flee. Now I understand why the destruction target is so high. I can't drive just yet, but there are more tanks trying to surround me. They each take a few shots to destroy, which I do while blowing up whatever objects I can in between. A few minutes of tank busting and Mac manages to get the tank moving. Next objective is to destroy all the Empyrean shipments. First there's the one pointed out in the cutscene. I then get onto this boat where more enforcers show up. Some have rockets but I can also just squish them. I exit the ship on the other side and get heading further down. There's still more tanks to deal with too. I don't like controlling the tank, it feels way too clunky and awkward and turning takes an eternity, even by video game tank standards. There are two more Empyrean shipments just out in the open and then I turn to the hardest part. Not only are there more tanks moving around the shipyard, but more enforcers have rockets. This is where that slow turning can fuck you over. Luckily, when left alone, the tank can regenerate health. There are four more shipments in this maze of shipping containers. The third one I destroy gives me the destruction target. After the fourth, the last two are already on a ship. The aiming's a bit awkward, but I get them and Mac and Bull escape in the tank. I unlock some form of Mac and some guy Duncan for the multiplayer. Maybe he's a cop I interrogated. Chapter 6, Escape. Mac somehow wrote off the tank, so Freak says they're just gonna have to steal another. He says Spanky is gathering up more killers to help and will meet us at the border crossing. First thing to do is have Bull break down this door leading into a town square. To get a tank to show up, I have to fight enforcers and destroy corporation property to incite a riot with the civilians. So I get doing that. I see this corporation statue with another of those spinning logos. Once again my shooting attempts didn't work, so I end up leaving it again. Stuff just blowing up around us as we get our first enforcers with riot shields to deal with. I take some grenades from dead enforcers, but I still need tear gas for the upcoming tank. Once the tank shows up, I get some and just lightly jog up to the tank to take it over. This time I don't have to control the tank, which is fortunate. While Mac drives, I play as Bull and man the minigun. As the tank moves, I have waves and waves of enforcers coming at me on foot, along with a few hiding high up in the buildings. Along with helicopters that take a while to shoot down before Mac gets stuck at a dead end and I have to mow down the idiots who think charging me will work. Mac shoots open a multi-story car park and goes in there. Of course, there's even more of them flowing in from above. I don't have much to say about this part, it's just three mates going up ramp shooting dudes. Then it's back down another street until I'm through this blown up sign, when I turn around and shoot down like 20 or 30 more enforcers in a few seconds. We reach another dead end and have to abandon the tank. We're at the border crossing, but there's more enforcers and a laser gate. The only way through is to find the controls and disable it. At that point, Spanky and the killers show up and they'll take on the guards as a distraction. I try to help them and get gunned down in no time. I'm supposed to sneak off to the left and go down this ladder, then use a mine to blow up the bars so I can get inside. I run through an empty corridor until a door opens and there's a load of enforcers ready for me. After them it's the ones with riot shields, followed by a couple more waves of normal enforcers. Then I'm taking on riot shields while dealing with a drone at the same time. All these corridors lead to a larger, more open room filled with explosive barrels. It looks like I've killed them all with the tiniest bit of health left, but just the second before I can grab that health pack, one dickhead comes charging in from the corner and kills me. Next time I kill the fucker. Then there's just a few more corridors of enforcers and drones where I grab my first assault rifle. It goes on for a while and it's really dull until I eventually reach the security room. Freak tells me to just destroy everything, so I do. Spanky and Bull have dealt with all the guards and with the drones and gates shut down, they can all get through. For the multiplayer, I unlocked Bull and the workers zone map. Couldn't reach the destruction target though. Chapter 7, Rescue Libra. In Capital City's workers zone, Mac is ready to return the favour for Libra getting him out of prison. Freak says the safest way to get to her is by air, so I'm going to have to steal a nearby helicopter. I now have a silenced gun as this chapter is all about stealth. Anyone gets alerted to me, they run straight for the nearest alarm and I get swamped. Thing is, this gun is wank to aim with. Reticle right on the guy's head and three shots still don't touch him. I can also shoot out the alarm so they can't be used. These guys are a bit stupid though. If the guy next to him is alerted, he won't be unless he either sees you himself or the alarm goes off. So if one sees me, it's best to just run up to that guy and gun him down. I clear out the first two sections and snipe a guy at a higher level before I climb this ladder. The guys on the second level are omniscient though, and shooting one enforcer has another out of view who can't possibly see him already halfway to the alarm and setting it off. So I get ganged up on, but still survive with the bare minimum health to climb another ladder where I'm killed in a second by the enforcers waiting for me. I do a lot better next time and get up with almost full health. Since no one was alerted this time, I can get to sniping the last lot of enforcers while they're unaware. But then I accidentally alert them looking for more and get pulverized. Next time I just play more carefully, but there's one hidden away to the left who still sees me. But this time I react quick enough to destroy the alarm and take them all out. The helicopter's there, but while shooting out the windows of this door, I see another of those logos inside. I shoot it and it works this time, so it was just being picky before. But now I know that the hidden objectives are these hidden targets in each level. This game is barely documented because no one cares, so finding this stuff was tougher than usual. Now I can take the helicopter. Freak can't find Libra, so he tells me to fly low around the city to see if he can get the signal from her phone's GPS. Thing is, there's turrets and enforcers underneath me with rockets, and they blow me up while Freak's still talking. There's a radio transmitter blocking Libra's signal that I'll have to destroy before we can start tracking her. But I just can't find a safe spot to turn and shoot out all those assholes below. So next time I just fly up as high as I can and start picking off the enforcers from the top down. I need to destroy as much as I can too because the destruction target is $750,000. I get killed a third time, but the fourth try is where I finally get it. I take out enough turrets to reach the destruction target. Next is that radio transmitter that explodes with little effort. Now, the bar on the left of the screen showing how close to Libra I am is active. More helicopters have been sent to wipe me out, but they're actually easier to deal with than the turrets and enforcers. Libra is being held near the huge bright conspicuous building towering above the others. I just lower myself a bit and there she is, so I gun down everyone around her. Libra can now get up and tells Mac to get going himself. She still has something left to do and gets climbing down the side of the building. This part is a huge pain. Libra jumps down slowly and there are always more enforcers leaning out of windows to shoot me. They tend to be spread out so it's quite easy to get shot while trying to find the next target. It doesn't help that the arrows pointing out enemies can be misleading here, leaving you to get shot a load while you follow it. Also got to watch out for those on the ground who also try approaching. Of course, I die, and quite close at the bottom too. It's not until my fourth try I finally manage to reach the bottom, and this level is still going as I get running through the streets. Enforcers try to stop me, but I fight through them as I bring Libra to the Justice Corps building she started the game in. And now I have to do the long, slow jumping segment again, but this time going up a building. Aside from the guy shooting me out the windows, I also now have two enforcers at a time rappelling down towards me. This time I finish it first try and get back inside. She connects Freak into the computer she was at when she was caught so we can start transferring the data. I now have to stay alive while the download slowly progresses. But since I'm already so close to death, you can guess it doesn't work this time. But I do somehow last for the download to reach 35%. Not all of the enforcers are focusing on me though. The other half of them are shooting at this surprisingly sturdy computer. I game over if it's destroyed before the download finishes. This time I make it to 62% before I'm killed. Next time I get creative. I plant mines by all the doors so that the enforcers will charge in and just blow up. It works out well, but I die as the download reaches 100%. I was not happy. Then, 85%, the enforcers destroy the computer. But next time I survive and the download finishes, Libra jumps out the window onto Mac's helicopter and they escape. I unlock Libra and Lance in multiplayer. Who's Lance? Chapter 8, The Plan. While looking through the data we stole, Freak finds a video pitch for Empyrean intended for selling it to other countries. They outright state that it alters the brain to suppress aspects like disobedience. It's not just being planted in the drugs they're dealing on the streets, but also in regular medication and food. Another stolen file shows the four Empyrean distribution centres in the workers' zone. Spanky wants to blow it up, but Freak still doesn't have an exact location on those centres and we're out of explosives. But the Mall Rats, another gang from the first game, should still have some left over. And so Spanky and Bull have to go over to the mall to sort out a deal. But this is another large city area like the ghetto, so first I have a long destruction spree to reach that target. Same stuff, windows, bus shelters, light up signs, enforcers picking fights. This time the target is $403,000. After about 12 minutes and running low on ammo, I decide to meet the Mall Rats. Bull explains everything to the leader and asks for their help. But they were raided by the enforcers 2 weeks earlier and had most of their firepower taken. So the solution's obvious, we take it back from the lockup. I also have a few Mall Rats joining me. I just follow my map to the lockup and get shooting. I run through the gate and lose loads of Spanky's health getting up this ramp. Swapping to Bull doesn't help as I reach the top of the ramp and I get shredded. Next time I do much better and clear out this section too. I think the issue is that I just find this game so dull that I keep trying to brute force to make it go faster, but doing that gets me killed. The door further in opens as shield enforcers have a go next. At this point all my Mall Rats are dead, so it's just Spanky and Bull. I go through the open door and take on the next wave. Freak tells me the explosives are in a weapon cache behind the garage. But first there's even more of them coming from that direction, but all the machine gun ammo I gained obliterates them. I almost die when another group sneaks up on me, but I switch in time and kill them too. I make it into the cache and take the explosives. Freak next tells me to plant them in the Empyrean offices. The biggest surprise in this chapter was no more enforcers on the way out. I thought I'd be fighting my way back. I reach the first marked building and have Bull break open the door. I place the explosives and I have to fight my way out. I'm still shooting any object I can on the way to the next one. Once again, break open door, plant bomb, shoot way out. I reach the third and it's the same process. On the way here I picked up some Molotovs, but they weren't that useful in a cramped space. Just one more left and here's something weird. When Bull goes to break the door, he's suddenly lit as if he's indoors before the door's even open. I plant the last explosive and fight off more enforcers. Freak tells me to return to the Mall Rats base, so I do. All four of the Empyrean officers go up in smoke. Spanky and Bull retreat and Mac takes over. We still need to destroy all the fast food places still containing Empyrean filled food. I return to the police precinct where they've restocked their enforcers. There are much less this time, so I easily make my way to the garage and take the tank inside. Now I get why this chapter has such a large destruction target. While I'm driving to these food places, the corporation is sending more tanks against me. I will say, as dull as the gameplay is, hitting enforcers with the tank and watching them bounce around at least has a small bit of fun in it. All it takes is one missile inside the buildings to blow them out. During my rampage, I reach that destruction target. I take out all the fast food places and finish the chapter by driving the tank back to the safe house. I unlock Piers in multiplayer, whoever that is, maybe the Mall Rats leader. Chapter 9, Broadcast. Libra and Spanky are sent to the industrial sector, where Mall Rats have already managed to infiltrate. Our job here is to broadcast to the general public what the corporation has been doing to them. He's marked out locations for me to place beacons that will help locate the corporation's satellite transmitter. Once the helicopter lands, I climb down and, as usual, get looking for things to destroy. But I can't find much. I do find a place to drop a beacon though. While that character that places it is saying it, the other one has to fight off enforcers targeting the beacon. Like the computer in Chapter 7, the beacon being destroyed is a game over. This first one is pretty easy and I chew through them. The second the last one dies, the beacon is set up, so I move on to the next one. However, this wave of enforcers gave me quite a bit of trouble, mainly because they enter at once from two opposite points and in the time it takes to turn around and take on the other group, you've been shot a lot. I found the best way to do it was to get on one side and shoot from there. I get to take out the ones coming in from the opposite side and the ones coming in from my side don't seem to react to me until they step past a certain point. This lets me keep an eye on all of them at once and easily shoot them all down. Riot dudes are still a pain though, try and shoot the 2 pixels of foot I can hit. Now for that last one. This is even harder for the same reason as the seconds, but this time there's a more wide space for the enforcers to move around in, so I don't have an easy method like last time. This took a few tries and simply required good aiming, reacting in time, and being aware of where every enforcer is after your multiple retries. Freak finds that the satellite is hidden in a gasometer in the gasworks. They head over to the gasworks, but can't get in because the keypad is code protected and only the foreman of this zone has it. So Spanky has to go find him and get the code out of him. He's very close by, so I just shoot him in the legs to stop him from getting away and start interrogating. But I accidentally kill him and have to find another foreman. There's another around the corner, and this time I get the code. I return to Libra and have her put it in to open the gate. A small group of Morvash show up to help as we charge in on the gasworks. There's a lot of explosive stuff around here, so I can get a lot of quick kills in, even if all but one of my Morrats died in 10 seconds. While an invincible AI Spanky takes on the enforcers, I just run around finding what I can to destroy. After a while, I get climbing the ramp onto the gasometer. Before climbing the ladder, I run around the back to find this chapter's hidden target and shoot it. I climb the ladder, which leads to me walking counterclockwise along this catwalk, taking out all the enforcers running around at me. I'm basically always taking two steps forward, leaning around the corner, shooting, and then repeating. I reach another ladder and get up it. Then I just have to do more of the same, but since I'm at such low health, I die. With restored health, I fight around to a third ladder that has me dealing with the shield fuckers. At the end of this third catwalk is the computer room, but it's filled with more enforcers. As soon as I kill the ones in view, I take one step in front of the door and promptly drop dead. Since I'm aware of the ones hiding to the left, I take them out too, followed by the one in the far back. I then spend a huge chunk of time shooting out all the computer monitors, only to find I'm still 300 grand away from the destruction target. I mess around with the main computer, making all TV screens display Freak as he shows the public about Empyrean. As Libra climbs back down, the gate shuts and the alarm goes off, but there's a tank down here I can steal. I get inside and Freak tells us to go to the workers' zone square. Before breaking out, I get blowing up everything around me and very quickly reach that 430,000 destruction target. I blast the gate open and get the usual enforcers and tanks as I make my way to this tunnel and escape. With the truth out to the public, a gigantic citywide riot breaks out. The military is sent in to bring down the riot, leaving the military base open for us to get in. Once again, I unlock a character I don't recognise the multiplayer, Betty. Chapter 10, Barracks. After we gravely wounded the corporation in the first game, they've moved their central offices to a heavily fortified island, with this military base in front of it. We need to clear this place out so we can get to that island and take them out before they can have their meeting with various world leaders to sell them Empyrean. First, Bull has to fight his way through a mass of enforcers alone to find the entrance to the sewage tunnel. This first section is easy, but then I turn a corner and there's loads of them. But there's some explosive barrels, so they're manageable. But as I head further in and turn another corner, that's when the helicopter shows up above and starts trying to shoot me. Luckily, its aim isn't perfect, so I take out the ground enforcers at the other side of its lane. I reach the end of the lane and then turn again towards the next. One of the enforcers around here drops a rocket launcher. There's also some crates I can shoot open for grenades. It takes a huge amount of misses, but I finally hit that helicopter with a rocket and bring it down. I reach the end of this lane, but before I move on again, there's enforcers in the next section I can kill early by shooting them through this fence. This makes it easier for me to reach the end of this section and take the ladder down into the drainage tunnels. First I break open this door, then go through the empty tunnel to break open another. I go through another doorway to find a locked door Freak can't open for me. So Libra takes over, starting off in the exact spot Bull started this level, but Freak opens a gate off to the side that leads to a ladder onto a roof. This is another stealth section like back in Chapter 7. I almost laughed when I loudly gunned these two guys down and shot the alarm speaker, then turned around and there was a guy stood right next to me with no idea what was happening. In the next section, they spot me just as I destroy the alarm, so they couldn't really do anything. This leads to another ladder that leads to more sneaking. This time I'm not so lucky. The enforcers that spot me are slippery bastards that avoid all my shots and manage to set off the alarm. But it doesn't matter as I reach this wall and have to do another tedious repelling section. This one is the worst to finish, as I have less space to shoot the enforcers and they're constantly shooting from windows below me, so I get killed while turning to find them. Let's just skip to 10 minutes later when I get past it, there's nothing interesting to it. I first spend a long time shooting all the monitors for that destruction target. However, it will turn out that I don't achieve that target this time. Once I finally use the computer, I open the door for Bull so he can get in. But there are now 4 locked doors, each with their own combination of coloured lights. I had to figure out which door leads to the next area and have Libra open it. Guessing the wrong door has me attacked by enforcers and I'll have to kill them all before I can try again. I guess it right first time, but I get curious about what's in the other room, since I don't know what happens if I get wrong yet. So I let myself get killed in the tunnel I opened. I try every wrong door I can, hoping to either find the hidden target or something to destroy. None of the wrongdoers have either of those. So what I'm gonna do is skim over half an hour of getting things wrong on purpose and getting killed and just show the correct path. So I go through the tunnel I opened first time and fight my way to the next room. This door here is the next correct one and I have to fight to another big room. And this door here is the last correct one I need to open, and it leads back outside. There's one last wave of enforcers to deal with and I take them out first try even with such low health. To end the chapter, I pull the switch to open the gate and let Spanky and the others through. While looking through files, Libra finds that the corporation has already been using Imperion on the military and the troops are all being controlled remotely. But she can't get any more information because the codes are on a memory chip. But Freak can trace a signal. Chapter 11, The General. Back to Spanky and Bull, more troops come in and I've gained a grenade launcher, a regular machine gun with a few grenades it can launch at the same time. There's a lot of troops and I last until there were only two left before I get killed myself. Despite there being knee-high cover, apart from leaning around walls, there isn't much of a cover system, so I'm out in the open getting shredded constantly. It's not until my sixth try I take them all out. But before I move on, the hidden target is just off to the side behind some boxes. I then go down the slope and through the gate. On this bridge we see the general trying to escape by boat. He has the memory chip, so we get in the boat ourselves and chase him. Spanky drives after him while Bull gets the rocket launcher to deal with all the boats and helicopters chasing us. These rockets home and come out at an incredible speed. The only downside to killing these guys so quickly is I hear the same, "Yeah, take a swim, bitch," voice clip from Bull every few seconds. It goes on for a few minutes until the general gets the machine gun out, so now I have to drive the boat myself and shoot at him. I have the grenade launcher for taking out helicopters while Bull automatically shoots enemies and the general if he gets close to them. Only issue is I have a hard time steering and keep ramming myself into walls, letting him get away, which is a game over. Next time I ignore everything else and just stay glued to him. After a certain amount of damage he'll change his route and start dropping mines behind his boat. He manages to gain a big lead as hitting a mine just stops you for a second, but I manage to catch up and almost deplete his boat's health, but he hits me with too many mines and I die, and then on subsequent attempts he keeps escaping. It doesn't help that I can be right on him and Bull just won't fire sometimes. In the end it takes about 7 tries to take out his boat. He pulls up and tries running off, so Bull goes after him while Spanky keeps the boat. I run through an empty street until I reach a square where General Mayhem is now backed up by a load of enforcers and is a floor higher where I can't reach. So I have to shoot him, the enforcers, and these windows for the destruction target. First, that $450,000 destruction target is reached, now I can focus on fighting. The general doesn't take that much damage, even from being shot in the head, so I pin him in a corner for a while with the grenade launcher. After enough damage, he escapes into a lift and more enforcers come in and kill me right before I'm about to heal. A couple deaths later, I take out his reinforcements and take him on again on the opposite side of the square. I take almost half his health before an enforcer kills me again. At about half health he gets on this turret, but that makes him a stationary target, so I then shoot out a huge chunk of his life. He then escapes back into the lift again. That's when the riot shields get involved. The general returns to where he started this fight and I reduce him to the last little bits of health. But he still escapes into another lift and his final set of reinforcements kill me. A couple tries later and I take them all out to make him face me himself, where I put a few bullets in his neck to finish him and take the memory chip. I return to the boat and Spanky sends the data in the chip over to Freak. I unlock Heavy Enforcer and Wireframe for multiplayer. I also somehow beat this chapter in under the 13 minutes needed for the time challenge, so this is the first chapter I won't need to replay. Chapter 12, HQ Island, the final level. Mac and Libra are stuck in the compound being shot at, but now Freak has the memory chip, he now has control of the soldiers, granting us a free army. I can now recruit them all like Spanky's gang members. Once I've done so, it's time to storm that bridge to HQ Island. There are 3 checkpoints along the bridge that I have to clear out on the way, but right away I get stunlocked to death by enforcers with rocket launchers. So next time I hang back and snipe them off from a distance. With them dead, I'm free to pull the switch to remove the first gate, only for a chunk of my soldiers to get rocketed to death. And once that guy's dealt with, so many more come pouring out that it slows down my game. And there's a helicopter above us too. Once again, I'm rocket stunlocked to death. I kill all the rocket users to make some turrets start shooting at me instead, but the rocket launcher I took from the soldiers I killed puts a stop to that. I take down the helicopter too. A few more troops and another turret and I can reach the second switch and remove that gate. Now I'm dealing with rocket dudes, a turret and a helicopter at once. And I couldn't snipe the rocket guy because my soldiers wouldn't get their great big heads out of the way, so Mac wound up near death and I had to swap to Libra who doesn't have a rifle. But at this point, just running and gunning is a viable strategy once the rocket user is dead. I make it to the final checkpoint and remove the gate, letting me on to HQ Island, where Bull and Spanky are already fighting. I shoot out everyone and turn to the next street where there's a tank facing me. If I turn left, there's a turret I can use to take it out. That leaves us free to attack the corporation's main building, and shoot out all her windows, of course. The enforcers are easy to deal with. The issue is two turrets way out in the back, and since Mac is so close to death, I daren't switch back to him and use the rifle. I manage to inch my way closer to them and lose a lot of health doing so. In the end, I backtrack for some grenades, but die on the way back. Next time I just rocket them and now all enemies are dead and I'm free to break everything. Then comes 5 minutes of me shooting every window because the destruction target is $1 million. But there's only enough for me to reach a quarter of that, so I approach the corporation's main building. All the corporation's executives are inside, working out the deal for selling the Empyrean. Mac's idea is to blow them all up right now. Freak points out a helicopter for him to steal and has been looking through the corporation's weapon inventory. And there's a boat on this island carrying a bomb strong enough to wipe out the entire island, and it's just left unattended. So the plan is to take the bomb, place it on top of the HQ building, and take all of them out at once. So Mac has everyone else evacuate the island while he gets in the helicopter. I still need to reach that destruction target though, so I spend a while flying around, shooting the helicopters that face me and any turrets, though I do get shot down myself a couple times. After about 10 minutes, I'm in the 800 grands, but I can't find anything else to destroy, so I go pick up that brimstone bomb. But before I can put it on the HQ, more helicopters show up to stop me. I easily take them out, place that bomb, and watch the island go kaboom and all the corporation leaders with it, which will allow the citizens to regain control of Capital City, since there's no one left to take over. I unlock freaking multiplayer, and it turns out nuking the island adds 10 times the destruction target to your total, so you can't not achieve it. No ending though, just credits. Of course, I'm not done yet. There's still the time, destruction, and hidden targets I missed to get. So back to chapter 1. The time target is to finish in less than 5 minutes 20 seconds, and I still have to find the hidden target. Well, for this one I just don't mess around, and since I know how to play the game, I clear it in 421, unlocking character masks. The hidden targets I have to find myself, as this game has barely any documentation, so I couldn't find a single location listed anywhere on the internet. For the hidden target, in the cell block, I climb this ladder in the middle, and at the top, the target is off to the side. For chapter 2, I have no idea what I'm supposed to do, as the time target is less than 3 minutes. I decide to look for the hidden target and reach for the destruction target first. It's right here on the rooftops on top of this. For the destruction target, I cause the last few bits of damage by shooting all this glass below me, leaving Bolt to get shot up. I unlock Heavy Guard in multiplayer. For the time target, I try to skip the drones and get past them as quick as I can, but I either get destroyed or it takes too long. Then, after about 20 minutes, I found out that they put a run button on one of the shoulder buttons and never told me about it the entire game. This would have been very helpful all those times I died while I was inches away from a health pack. I simply ignore all the enemies and belt it past them. If I die, so what? I get checkpointed later on in the level with my health refilled and timer rolled back to when I first reached it. The problem is the sniper section at the end. If Bull gets knocked on his ass on his way to the next warden office, you lose time. So I end up finishing just 6 seconds late. But I eventually knock back time to 2:57, unlocking tiny characters. In chapter 3, after exiting the building, I look up to the left with the sniper to find the hidden target. The time target is 6:30 for this one, so I just use the same strategy. Brute force it, running past all the enemies I don't need to kill. After 20 straight minutes of getting killed, the stars align and I just run past everything I can to unlock huge characters with a time of 5:41. In chapter 4, near the Enforcer's drug lab, the hidden target is up the stairs behind a bit of scenery. 5:50 is the target for this one. This is one of the easier ones. Outside of the opening section, there's only the shootout after the interrogation and then the drug lab where I'm under real threat of death. Also, you've got to make sure you get the interrogation perfect. Any weak hits just waste time. I do die quite a bit at the drug lab, but once I'm past it, I've unlocked the no radar option for clearing it in 5:21. For chapter 5, I already know where the hidden target is, only this time it actually recognises me shooting it. The time target is also 5:50 here. With how slow the tank moves, it feels like you'll never get it in time, which leads to you rushing and getting blown to shit. It's 25 straight minutes of ignoring enemies and hoping they miss enough shots before I finally blow up all the shipping containers and unlock the farmyard noises option to clearing it in 5:45, just 5 seconds under the target. Once again, I already know where the hidden target is in chapter 6 and make sure I hit it. This time I reach for destruction target, but I don't feel like I did anything different, so I have no idea where I got that extra damage from. This unlocks whoever Helmut is for multiplayer. The time target is 13:20. This is so generous because a massive chunk of the level is the automated tank section, so I just have to make sure I'm running full speed whenever I'm not in the tank. This is one of the easiest to reach, unlocking the one-shot kills option for clearing it in exactly 10 minutes, 3 full minutes under the target. Chapter 7 only has the time target left, 9 minutes. Once again, fuck stealth, just run. This gets me to the helicopter in just less than 1 minute, then straight to the radio transmitter and to the building where Libra's being held. Repelling is slow, not much you can do about that. Then belt it to the end and the download section takes a set amount of time. I unlock the rapid fire sniper option for finishing it in 6:48. For Chapter 8, the hidden target is above this roof in the police precinct. I have 10 minutes for this stage as time target. It's actually a pretty simple one. The only huge firefight is zooming the mall rats against the police. Everything else is a quick, small skirmish. So as long as I keep all of that run burn, I have plenty of time to do the slower tank section. I unlock invincibility with a final time of 9:15. For Chapter 9, it's just the time target, also 10 minutes. For this one, it's mainly running, then several deaths in a row trying to rush each firefight until I get the successful one where the beacon is set. Then, for climbing the gasometer, I just zigzag past every enforcer at full speed to avoid their fire. But eventually they get strong enough that I do have to slow down a little and actually kill them to stay alive. I unlock infinite ammo with a time of 7:56. In Chapter 10, the hidden target is in this alcove in the first sewer section as Bull. The destruction target in this level is definitely the hardest though. You need to destroy absolutely everything. Doing so unlocks the soldier in multiplayer. The time target is 9:30. In comparison, this is easy. Another fuck the enemies just run level. Just make sure you open all the right doors in the last section and you unlock the exploding death option. My time was 5:48, so you have plenty of time to make mistakes. The time target for Chapter 12 is a very generous 20 minutes, and anyone playing normally should get it. Of course, I was shooting out every window first time, so I didn't. I unlocked 8-bit mode with a time of 13:11. As for the final hidden target, just take a few steps forward and look up. There it is. I can't believe I never noticed it twice before. Getting them all unlocks battle mode in multiplayer. Now that should be the end of the game, but there's still arcade mode to get through, so let's just get this over with. It's a series of shortish challenges with bronze, silver and gold rankings depending on how well I do. First is the sniper challenge where I have to shoot prison guards during a riot. Killing the prisoners results in a 5-second penalty each. A single kill is worth 1 point, and quick successive skills are worth bonus points, the bonus increasing by 5 every time the more I keep the combo up. This makes it easy for me to reach the 120 points for gold with over 30 seconds left. I finish with 198 points, unlocking Super Sniper Challenge and Ghetto Chaos. Next is the Helicopter Challenge. I've got to fly around the prison island killing all 17 enforcers. No real tips for this otherwise, just be quick and memorise where they all are. It only takes me 2 tries to clear it in 1 second under the 1 minute 20 for the gold. I unlock the Mini Tank Challenge. Super Sniper Challenge next. This time the enforcers are harder to shoot as they're always running and never stop. To make up for it, I only need 80 points for gold. This one just takes practice, and after 2 disastrous first attempts, my third has me with over 100 points with a minute 20 remaining. I finish with 222 points, unlocking the Mounted Gun Challenge. Ghetto Chaos next. This is supposed to be a recreation of the first game's main Chaos mode, except it's just not as fun because this game style of gameplay is a lot slower and doesn't suit it as well. So yeah, I'm just playing as Bull, shooting up everything I can in the Chapter 5 environment. I can get bonus time from killing enforcers and even better bonuses through headshots. It's easy enough to rack up the multipliers, but it just makes me wish I was playing the first game instead. Even the announcer shouting over it is more repetitive and less memorable. I reach the $550,000 in damage for gold with 25 seconds left and unlock Workers' Zone Chaos. Next is Mini Tank Challenge. There's 36 enforcers around this map and I have to kill them all with this tank as quick as I can. The target for gold is to clear it in less than 130. I just have to drive around the Chapter 8 map looking for them all and then memorise where they are. It takes about 6 attempts, but I eventually do it in 124. It unlocks the Rocket Challenge. Then comes the Mounted Gun Challenge. This one drove me up the wall. I have a crowd of rioting prisoners constantly under attack by enforcers, and I have to keep them alive as long as possible. Timer stops when they're all dead. Thing is, enforcers are in with the crowd, so it's too easy to do their job for them and kill prisoners while aiming at enforcers, and the less prisoners there are, the quicker they start dropping dead. They also get backed up by helicopters and turrets, and dealing with them means taking your eyes off the ones in the crowd. This is another one where the only solution is to play it a lot and memorise which side of the screen the enforcer's coming from and when. The worst moment was 10 minutes in when I lost my last prisoner 2 seconds away from the gold. In the end, this one took me 20 minutes for that 2 minute survival. Now we have Workers' Zone Chaos, where I'm swapping to Spanky, and the aim is $800,000 in damage to the Chapter 8 map. It's a bit tougher as I now have tanks to take on while on foot, but there are more limited bonuses such as for destroying windows. This one took around 20 minutes too. You need to gather a lot of time bonuses and stay alive for a long time. The arcade mode exclusive chain gun is a good weapon for dealing with huge mobs of enforcers and racking up a huge bonus though. In this attempt, I go beyond the $800,000 for gold and finish with over $1,117,000 in damages. Rocket challenge next. I'm still on the bridge to HQ Island with a rocket launcher, shooting at approaching enforcers and helicopters with the odd tank every so often. My feet are glued to this spot so I can't dodge. Not much else to this one, and it takes me 4 attempts to survive the 2 minutes 30 seconds required for gold. In fact, I survive for over 3 minutes. This unlocks the speedboat challenge. And that's the next one. It's just a boring drive-through rings challenge. There's a couple mines in the water and a part constantly swapping sides under this bridge to throw you off. But it only takes me 3 tries to finish in 1 minute 33 seconds, 2 seconds under the target for gold. This unlocks the mounted gun 2 challenge. But first is the enforcer challenge, where I have to pilot a helicopter and destroy a speedboat. It takes me about 5 minutes to get the pacing and distance right for constant homing missile shots so that I can finish it in less than a minute for the gold. This unlocks Rocket Challenge 2 while I'm just begging the game to let me be done already. Next is another speedboat race where I'm actually racing other boats, and this one is a pain in the arse. If another boat rubs against you from behind, you just lose all momentum and stop deading your tracks and you're not winning. It takes 10 minutes for me to win this one in 1:31, coming first for the gold. Fuck this one, moving on. Mounted Gun Challenge 2, now we're moving on to Libra's challenges. This time all the enforcers are coming for me, so I just have to survive as long as I can. There are some cars I can blow up to take out a few at once. The biggest threats are any enforcers with rocket launchers that are off screen, because you can lose most of your health while turning to face them. I die the first time, but this is one of the easier ones, so in my second try I survive past the 3 minutes for the gold. Rocket Challenge 2. This time I'm on the abandoned street from Chapter 6, but it's barely any different to the first one. The gold is surviving for a minute 30 seconds, and I get that on my second try. Helicopter Challenge 2. 3 minutes in the helicopter section of Chapter 7 to kill as many enforcers as possible, with the gold requiring 60. I've already explained how easy it is to die in the level this place is from. It takes me 15 minutes to get that target. Getting there, just one left. Enforcer Tank Chaos. Drive a tank around the Chapter 8 map and blow everything up. This time I'm playing as an enforcer, so I'm encouraged to mow down civilians. The playable cast will also show up for me to kill for a huge bonus. In a more fun game, this would be a worthy final challenge, but instead it's a boring slog with me just waiting for that point counter to reach 200,000. But every failure is just the game denying me from being done. When you're close at this point and you die out of nowhere, you get annoyed. And in the end, it took 24 minutes until I hit that 200 grand, getting all gold on every challenge. That's the game fully completed as well. All cheats unlocked and all multiplayer characters too. Multiplayer is nothing special, just the usual deathmatch and flag stuff. I doubt if I had a second player it would make the game any more fun. There's a last man standing mode where I tried to kill all enforcers running around, but that's about it. The first State of Emergency was a game I wasn't expecting much from, but it turned out to be one of the biggest surprises on this show for how fun I found it. State of Emergency 2, on the other hand, is probably the biggest disappointment since finally getting to play 40 Winks and not liking it. Literally everything in this game was downgraded. The fast-paced arcade feel was dropped for a slower, blander, third-person shooter style that feels especially underwhelming for 2006. The story may now have actual cutscenes and acting, but the many missions and text box-only dialogue the first game had let them fit in loads more story. The over a third of the game's story deals with a boring prison break, followed up by another rescue mission, only leaving the last third or so to deal with taking on the corporation, doesn't help. Nor does the focus on Mac, who gets the most limelight and is the most boring. Maybe if he was still wearing loud Hawaiian shirts it would give him some character, but instead most of the game is spent on the most generic looking character making shit quips, sounding like he's failing to pull off a Solid Snake impersonation with the gravelly voice. Soundtrack is completely forgettable. No music ranking for now, by the way. I couldn't find the game's soundtrack anywhere, and my own attempts at ripping it didn't exactly go well. And even in the arcade mode, where we do get something closer to the first game, the changes in gameplay sucks out the fun. Far from the worst game I've ever played, it's not bad enough for that, but it is one of the most disappointing for its blandness. And there's my second full series completed on this show. One surprisingly good game followed by a bland sequel that squanders the potential. Really, I feel this is how most 2-game franchises go. Huge shame. If you want to get out your frustrations with evil corporations and act out a violent uprising, you're better off with the first game. Not only is it better, it's much cheaper.